Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitcher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give you an example of the solitary people who work for God and they damn care for what the world thinks of them or what they talk about them. I gave you an example of a priest in Romania, a young one, who understood my views, but he was frightened that what the people were talking about me was so bad that he could not tell me what they were saying. Remember that I visited Romania last year, and over there, you know, this young priest, I met him in the church by chance, the Protestant church, and I explained to him, he was interested, and I explained to him the baptism of John, how to become son of man, and I told him that he baptized men only in the name of Abraham, and he understood it, and I was very happy that he understood the basic, you know, and then he will understand the rest. So he was very keen, but when he talked to the other people, or the other people talked about me, because I had taken with me a poster in which I have shown the priest to be a dog, have putting on this the Antichrist cross around his neck. You know, these priests put on cross around their neck, which people kiss and all that. This is the sign of Antichrist, because in Christ, what comes out of your mouth, that matters, not these robes or whitewashed cups they become. Jesus had already condemned these whitewashed cups full of filth. So these Antichrist were not happy with my poster. And when I told them that you cannot get payment, you cannot be paid in Mammon working for God. If you are paid by Mammon, then you are working for Mammon, and you hypocritically pretend that you are working for God. So they were very much against me, that this man from India, he is not good, you know, he is calling us bad names and this and that. So when he heard all that thing, so he said, oh, is this so bad they talk about you? I can't tell you. I asked him, tell me what they say. He said, no, I can't tell you. So however, whatever I mean to say, that he was so frightened when the testing time came, he couldn't stand, because he too wanted to work for Mammon. He wanted to accept money. He told me his conscience say, you know, that one should not accept money when working for God. At St. Paul was a tent maker. I was very happy to when he told me that. But again, you know, when the testing time came, he loved Mammon more than God. So he was not so enthusiastic about gospel then anymore. He just became a cold shoulder. Whereas, you know, I have some brethren, and one of my brethren, Harry Jackson is his the name on the YouTube. He sent me a letter or his description how he loved God and what he did. 4 pages, you know. He said, you know, he went in the cold winter in December up on the hill, and He was asked to undress himself, take all the clothing off and walk, you know. Now, he wanted me to interpret it. Now, this clothing, taking clothing, if you read Gospel of St. Thomas, he said we are like little children who take off our clothing. Clothing means this robes, you know, people are putting on, which are dog-collared people putting on to show to other people that they are this and that. These robes of hypocrisy, we have to take them down. We have to be simple like any other person and take them down, and we trampled over it like little children do. Little children mean clean-hearted people. So he was a clean-hearted person. He is a clean-hearted person, and for the love of God, he did crazy things like being naked in the cold, suffering cold, kicking, you know, doors and this thing. And but his intentions, his desire was to find God. So he was taken for a tramp, and he was taken for a madman, you know, that they wanted to give him a tranquilizer and all those medicines. He did not accept it. So slowly, you know, he cooled down, and he loved my preaching, and he had been appreciating my preaching, and he himself, he's a seeker. He's not a blind follower. He's a fully enlightened seeker, and he feeds me with the things, you know, which are surprising me too. Because in preaching gospel, we exchange views. We do not follow anyone. We are both solitary, and we are both exchanging views. I listen to him, and he listened to me. Same we have Brother Gary in America. He too is a solitary. And we just exchange views, because in Jesus you cannot make disciples of following as these Billy Graham and these people are doing. They are anti-Christ. They only know sin. Sin is the regime of the anti-Christ, because in God we are no more slave to the sins but to the righteousness. So people who are of God, they always talk about righteousness. Righteousness comes from your heart. So Christianity is the religion of the heart. So brother, keep on, you know, preaching gospel. Do not be frightened of anyone. Preach gospel from the rooftop. As I have put that shirt, you know, which has the logos, people may laugh at me. What this man is putting on, all that, but I don't care. I know what I'm doing. I'm solitary. So should we all solitary. And we should get t-shirts made, then put gospel on that one and let the people ask, because we need people who are living. The dead man doesn't ask. The living are very few. So with that gospel written over your shirt, we will pick up the living ones, and then we can fish them into the royal kingdom of God, as Christ Jesus fished those who were chosen. They were solitary, they were not a following Jesus. But they of one accord. God bless you.